Hey everyone. So I was a bit stuck about what to do for my next video until a friend of mine suggested that I can talk about my blush collection. Now that was a very good suggestion because right around the time that I got into makeup, I have been crazy about blushes. There was a time when I wanted to create like a very big collection of all the blushes that I could get my hands on. I do think that blushes do make you look more finished, more preened, more done, and they add that extra glow to your face when you need it. Unfortunately, I downsized my blush collection just last month because, like I said earlier, I had a huge collection of blushes and I realized I wasn't using most of them. Some of them had expired, so I sort of threw them away, gave some of them away. I think some brands that do fantastic blushes are Lakme, Rimmel, NYX, and MAC for sure, but I don't have any blushes from those brands right now because I gave them away, and the ones that I have with me right now are like my current favorites or the ones that I use on a daily basis. So this is my downsized current go-to blusher collection. So the blushes that I'm going to show you today are in no particular order except for the first one, because it's my absolute favorite out of all the blushes that I have right now, and it's the Maybelline Fit Me blush in the shade Deep Coral. Now this is a matte finish and a true coral. Now this sort of has a bronzy undertone, but it's not too overwhelming. It is a true coral any which ways. This just works well with anything that you put on your eyes or anything that you put on your lips, and I think it just looks really great with my skin tone. It's just easily my favorite, and it's the one that I use almost 5 out of 7 days of the week. My next blush is from Makeup Revolution and it's almost the same as Deep Coral, although this sort of has a pinky undertone as opposed to the bronze undertone that Deep Coral had. I have a dupe for this one. It's the Essence Silky Touch blush in Autumn Peach. If you compare it, it almost looks the same. Both of them are peach with a pinky undertone. Now the Makeup Revolution blush has no shimmer in it, which I think is great because then you can just apply your highlighter wherever that you want on your cheeks. Also, this has a bit more pink, so it shows up on your skin. So on lazy days when you know that you don't want to put too much effort into your makeup, this is a very good option. It's buildable, but it's not very pigmented, so it's really good when you're not sure about which blusher to use, because half of the times even I don't know what I'm putting on my face. So if you get it wrong, it's not going to show up, and I think it's good if you're not sure what blusher to use. Another blush in the Sheer family that I have is the Savannah Colors blush in the shade 03. Now this is a true neon bright pink, but because of the finish, it's very, very buildable. This looks amazing with smoky eyes and neutral lips, and it adds that pop of color on your cheeks. It's more of a going out blush and not something that I'll wear during the day, but it's still a very good color to have in your collection. The next blush is from Ashley Cosmetics. It's a brand that I came across on my last trip to Thailand. I hadn't seen or heard about this brand anywhere, but the color really called to me. It's a very, very nice pinkish red shade, and it doesn't have shimmer, so you can put your highlighter wherever that you want to. And it's a very nice color, definitely something that you also have to have in your stash. The next blush is from a very, very underrated Indian makeup brand, I think. It's the Studio West Pure Passion Radiance Blush in the shade Pink Quartz. It's a peachy pink and it's not in your face. So what I love about it is that you can use it on a daily basis and not worry about your makeup being too loud. And another one that I love but kind of gets overlooked is the Maybelline Cheeky Glow Blush in Peachy Sweetie. This is almost the same as the Makeup Revolution blush, and it doesn't have any shimmer in it, and it's just fantastic for nights out because it photographs so well. I think in the pan it doesn't look like much, which is why it gets overlooked very, very badly, but once it's on your cheeks, it's really, very flattering. And that has been my current blush collection. If anyone has any video ideas, please let me know. I've been kind of stuck with the kind of videos that I've been doing for the past few weeks. I mean, I've done like my top 10 budget favorites and similar things on those lines. And I've also been doing my monthly favorite, but I would like something different to add a little bit of variety to what I'm doing right now. And so if any of you have any recommendations, please let me know them in the comments below, and I'll try my best to do them. And I hope you like this video, and thank you for watching. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.